Welcome to Adult YPWW, Lesson 4. I do not own the rights to this music. The topic is, God brings us into His presence by His Spirit. The lesson text is coming out of Ezekiel chapter 3, verses 10 through 15. I do not own the rights to this music. Moreover, He said unto me, Son of man, all my words that I shall speak unto thee, receive in thine heart, and hear with thine ears. And go, get thee to them of the captivity unto the children of thy people, and speak unto them, and tell them, Thus saith the Lord God, whether they will hear, or whether they will forbear. Then the Spirit took me up, and I heard behind me a voice of great rushing, saying, Blessed be the glory of the Lord from his place. I heard also the noise of the wings of the living creatures that touched one another, and the noise of the wheels over against them, and a noise of a great rushing. So the Spirit lifted me up and took me away, and I went in bitterness, in the heat of my spirit. But the hand of the Lord was strong upon me. Then I came to them of the captivity at Telabib, that dwelt by the river of Chebar. And I sat where they sat, and remained there astonished among them 7 days. The lesson aim says, the aim of all the lessons for this quarter is to explore and gain insight into the work of the Holy Spirit in the life of every believer. The memory verse says, Then the Spirit took me up, and I heard behind me a voice of a great rushing, saying, Blessed be the glory of the Lord from his place. And that's Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 12. The introduction says, One of the greatest luxuries available to modern humanity is air travel. Although it has its dangers, it has proven to be a quick and safe manner in which to get from place to place. Before the plane can become airborne, the passengers must do certain things. They must fasten their seat belts. They must make sure their dining trays are put back in place. They must return their seats to an upright position. These things must be done before the plane can reach its cruising altitude. For airplanes, cruising heights are important. By flying on a certain level, they are able to overcome many of the storms and mountains that will ordinarily obstruct their course. So it is in the case of Christians. Maintaining a high spiritual altitude enables him or her to overcome the obstacles that relate to daily living. As it is to be expected, there are certain things that he or she must do in order to become airborne in God. The discussion says, Son of man is the translation of the Hebrew term Ben Adam. In the book of Ezekiel, it is used to denote the humanity of the prophet. The Lord applies this title to Ezekiel to remind him that he is like other people. That is to say, God keeps the prophet mindful of his biological connectedness with humankind. The reference to the captivity pertains to those persons who were part of the first deportation. Gerhard von Grad, a premier Hebrew Bible scholar, comments that the Israelites were carried to Babylon in stages. The first group left Jerusalem in 597 BC, and the last group left in 587 BC. Only the top 10% of the population was carried to Babylon. The poor and uneducated persons were left in Jerusalem. Ezekiel was among the first group of deportees. Then the Spirit took me up. These words refer to the prophet being allowed to enter into the realm of the Lord, wherein the Holy Ghost heightened Ezekiel's spiritual awareness, for the purpose of preparing the prophet for a deeper spiritual encounter with the Most High. Telabib was the location where Ezekiel and a group of the deportees lived. It was a city that was built near the Chebar River. H.G. May argues that the city's name actually means Mound of the Flood. In conclusion, if the Holy Ghost is to lift us, we must, 1, recognize our need to be lifted. 2, recognize our inability to lift ourselves. And 3, recognize the responsibility that comes with being lifted. Since we are human, there will be times we are down. If we are ever going to overcome those down times in life, we must access ourselves to the raising power of the Holy Ghost. We must learn to dwell in the secret place of the Most High. The Spirit of God does the raising up. He moves on our minds and elevates us to the point where we can receive what the Lord wants to give us. The Holy Ghost takes us into the realm where the peace of God dwells. Because of that, we must remember that we are unable to lift ourselves. Moreover, we must understand that the Lord reveals himself to us so that we may be of some good to ourselves and to other persons. He gives deep spiritual revelations so that his people can be edified. Thus, being allowed into the realm of the Most High means that we have an obligation to be of service to each other. Life is filled with so many disturbing things, even within the Church of God in Christ. There are personalities, practices, and principles that may cause one to get discouraged. But such is life. That is why God desires to bring us into his presence. He chooses to use his Spirit as a vehicle to transport us from low-flying altitudes to higher flying heights. Remember the praise song, "I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. Singing glory, hallelujah, Jesus lifted me." Jesus lifts us. Jesus lifts us through the Holy Ghost. Praise a mighty God. The question for today's lesson. Question 1. Define the term Ben Adam. Question 2. Who was Gerhard von Rad? Question 3. Which group of Israelites was deported? Question 4. Why is it imperative that we be lifted by the Holy Ghost? Question 5. What do the words, "Then the Spirit took me up," mean? And question 6. What 3 things must we do if we want the Holy Ghost to lift us? The end. God bless you, and thank you for joining me today.